Good morning students. Today we are going to study new lesson work and energy. Okay, in this lesson now you can see the terms work and energy. You are very familiar with this work words because in our daily life you are using this word work. Means whatever you are doing in your home, that you call work. But actually what is the meaning of work, that in physics it is differently used. Okay, so what it is you are going to study in this lesson? Energy, different forms of energy you have studied in previous classes. Different types of energies are there: mechanical energy, electrical energy, magnetic energy. Okay, these also we are using, such as chemical energy we are using in our daily life. But here we are going to study the concept work and energy. So both are related to each other, work and energy. In our daily life, what you can do, if you get energy, if you have energy, you can do the work. But in physics it is little different. We are going to study, both are related to each other. We are going to study, first we will study what is work. Okay, now what is the work? You can see here, I will take a duster. Okay, now I am applying a force on this duster. You can see I am applying a force on this duster in this direction. If I apply a force, the duster moves in this direction. Means what? Work is done on the duster. Means if you are applying a force on any object and it displaces, then it is called work is done. Now you can see this is a duster and I am applying a force and it is moving in this direction. So I can say that the work is done on the duster. Okay, so that you can see, when a force is applied on a body in order to change its position, means what? For the work done, what you have to do, you have to apply a force and the object should displace from its position, then only you can say the work is done. Okay, another example I will tell you. If I am pushing a wall, okay, if I am pushing a wall, what happens? Will the wall move? Okay, it will not move. Okay, I am applying, there also I am applying a force. Means we can say I am doing work on the wall, but wall is not moving. No, here what happens, the work is not done, because you can say here force is done. Means I am applying the force on the wall, but wall is not moving. Means there is no displacement, so you cannot say that work is done. So there are conditions of work. What are the two main conditions? If the work is done, if you want to say the work is done, the two conditions should be satisfied. First condition is that the force should be applied. Okay, this is the first condition. Force should be applied on an object. And the second condition is what? The object should be displaced. This is very important. The object should be displaced, then only you can say the work is done. If only you are applying force but there is no any response from the object, means it is not moving, it is a steady position, then what happens? You can say that work is not done. The object should be displaced. This is the two conditions. Then only if the two conditions are satisfied, you can easily say that the work is done. Okay, see the definition here. Work done is defined as, it is the product of force. Okay, force, which is in small letter alphabet, it can be written as F, and the displacement S, small s. Okay. It is the product of the force and displacement produced in the body. Initially you can write it as work W equal to force F into displacement S. As it is the product of force and displacement, it is written like this. Okay, here actually it can be one more sentence. We have not studied the trigonometry. It is also work done is equal to Fs cos theta. Cos theta, it is the angle. Now here you have studied, it is the product. Means there is an angle between the force and displacement, and the angle is the cos theta, that you will study later, because you have not studied trigonometry. So till here you will study that work done is equals to force into a displacement. Okay, then which quantity it is? Work done, it is a scalar quantity, and the SI unit of work is joule, J-O-U-L-E, joule, and in short form it is written as J. Okay, this is the work. Okay, understood this? Now what happens? Now this is the unit is 1 joule. Okay, here unit is joule. So what is 1 joule? That I will explain you. Here you can see the joule. okay, now I will explain you what is 1 joule of work done. If I am telling I have done 1 joule of work, means what? That now suppose this equation I have taken is work done equal to force into displacement. Okay, now I am telling that 1 newton of force is applied on an object, okay, on any body it is applied, 1 newton of force, and it displaces the object 1 meter. Means if you are applying a force of 1 Newton and it moves 1 meter, then you can say 1 joule of work is done. Understood? Very simple it is. You can see when a force 1 Newton is applied on a body and this force displaces the body by 1 meter. Okay, if the body is displaced 1 meter, then you can say that the work is done. Here the equation I have written, force, unit of force is 1 Newton, unit of displacement is 1 meter, so it becomes 1 Newton meter, that is 1 joule. So this way you can say that 1 joule of work is done. Here next statement you can see 1 kJ, kJ means what? Kilo joule it is, okay. So kilo means you know it is 1000, so 1000 joule, okay. This quantity it is used for problem solving. Now, next topic I will explain you that it is types of work. What is types of work now? You all know you are familiar with the work, but what is the types of work? In the work also there are different, 3 different types, that is positive work, negative work and zero work. Okay, so now you will think what is this 3 types of work, positive, negative and zero. I will explain you. Now you know, if I am applying the force in this direction, the duster move in this direction only. Okay, means the direction of force applied. Now I am applying the direction in this direction and the duster is displacement is also done in the same direction. If the direction of force is equal to the direction of displacement, equal means it is same. If the duster is moving in left, the force is also applied is left. Okay, so what happens in this both condition, we call it as a positive work. Means the direction of displacement is equal to the direction of force. Means it is in both are in the same direction. Then you can say it is a positive work. Examples, you know, whatever we are doing everyday life, it is a positive work. If you are pushing anything, it goes in the same direction where the force is applied. So it is a positive work. Now what is negative work? Negative work, opposite to this positive work, if you are applying the force in one direction and the displacement is done in opposite direction. Now you will think how it can be. Okay, means I am applying the force in this direction and how the object can move in opposite direction. Okay, for that one example I will tell you, a ball. As every time we are taking the example of a ball, if you are throwing a ball upside, what happens? It comes downwards. Means the force which you are applying is upward. You are throwing the ball upward, but when it goes at some extent and it comes down. So what happens? The displacement is opposite to the direction of force. Here it is called as negative work. Understood? So here you can see, so what will be the equation for the positive work? What equation it becomes for the positive work? You can say that W equal to force into displacement. It is positive as regular equation. Negative means here displacement comes negatively. It goes opposite to the gravity, against the gravity. When you are throwing a ball, the ball moves against the gravity and then it comes back. Means while coming back, it is the displacement is opposite to the force applied. So what happens here? Equation becomes W equal to force into minus S. Okay, because the direction of displacement is negative, so force equals to minus S. And zero work. Now what is zero work? Zero work means the direction of force applied is perpendicular to the direction of displacement. Okay, means now both, if I am applying the force in this direction, the displacement is like this, perpendicular to that, then you can say that the work done is zero. Now here which example I should give you? I will tell, if you are carrying a heavy load on your head, you can see the porters on railway stations, what they used to do, they carry the luggage and their heavy luggage is on their head. Now in this condition what happens? They are applying the force on upward direction as the luggage is on their head. So they are applying the force on upward direction. Okay, and they carry the luggage is straight. Okay, they move this way, any way they can move. But the applied force is straight upward and they are moving like this. Means they are moving in this way and the force is applied this way. So what happened? This become perpendicular. So whenever this two becomes perpendicular to each other, the work done is zero. Here also you will think why it becomes perpendicular. As I told you here, work is equals to Fs cos theta. When you will study later on the concept trigonometry, in that you will study the cos theta. Theta means the angle between these two. If you will take this angle, okay, between the force and displacement angle is produced, and this angle cos theta, if you will take the value of theta, if you will take 90, it becomes 0. That's why you can say the work done at this condition will be 0. If you will go mathematically, you can see that while solving this work done, means if you will take the force as displacement, cos theta you will take, cos theta as here considered is 90 degree. If you will take this 90 degree, what happens? The force you are getting is 0. Sorry, the work done which you are getting is 0. That's why it is called as zero work. Means mathematically also it can be proved that this type of work is 0. Or it can be also said that there is no displacement. A zero work means there is no displacement, only force acts but there is no displacement. Okay, understood this concept? Okay, read the notes which I am sending along with this. Thank you.